Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Folks, today what I wanted to talk to you all about is a really cool piece of software that I use on Linux. It's not open source, unfortunately, but I wanted to do a video about it anyway, considering you can use it on Linux. And other Linux YouTubers have talked about this in the past, so I'm not exactly special, but let's talk about it anyway. Let's talk about Ocenaudio. So, folks, right now you're looking at Ocenaudio, and if I actually play some sound for you...
So if you want your next commercial to...
See, so I can come in here... Let me cut that out, let's say, at the beginning. Say I want this next one to cut out. And then we can come back here and play. So I like it because it's simple to edit.
So if you want your next commercial to sound like this.
See? And so if I just wanted that, I'm good to go. I can go ahead and I can come up here and I can export it and we're done. And you can see I can export it as a WAV file, you know, all kinds of different stuff. We can come over here and look at the actual audio spectrum here, the... I forget what this is called every time, because the spectrograph view, here it is. So we can come here and look at where what frequencies are being used, and this is really great because you can see cuts in here that are very obvious and stuff too, so you can try to hide fades in it. You can even have both of these up at the same time. So like, for example, to show the cut thing, that right there, actually that kind of looks pretty smooth to me.
Commercial this. Commercial.
Yeah, it doesn't sound smooth, but it looks a lot smoother. But I have to admit, I'm not really perfect at reading these, but I guess you could see the cut a little bit right here. If we zoom, yeah, you can kind of see that line right there. So I usually leave it on this view, and I don't use this for a final mix or anything. This is more just to kind of chop stuff up, and then I usually export it into Audacity. If it's audio only, if it's for a video, then I usually don't even use this at all. I usually just use DaVinci Resolve for the entire audio process. But anyway, so the software can do a bunch of different things. I can come in here and I can do compression, for example. So we could compress the audio. We could do all kinds of different things. We could normalize. So, I mean, we have some options. And I could come in here and I could adjust the volume. For example, if I select something and just have that be adjusted, that can be helpful, right? You can zoom in. And so you can like zoom around here and we can get like really detailed zoomed in, literally to the sample level. Look at this one sample, two samples right there. I'm not kidding. And let's go ahead and here we go. There we go. And now I can drag this back out. So as you can see, I can do some interesting things here. I can control my playback. I can even loop it. I can change the speed. I can play just the selected components. I have options. I can like change my routing settings here, right? So anyway, regardless, it's a pretty cool piece of software. It's available on Linux. I advise you all check it out. Everybody, thanks so much for watching Open Source Tonight. Hope you enjoyed today's video. And until next time, thanks for watching. Goodbye, everybody. And action.